is because of the species of trees that are planted. We should be planting smaller trees that have a smaller root system, thereby reducing sidewalk damage. This is a very important action to reduce further future sidewalk damage. The liability for sidewalks should not be given to the property owners. The majority of the sidewalk damages are because of city trees. The property owners are not allowed to cut the trees, are not allowed to prune them. We have no control over the cause of the sidewalk damage. Property owners would have an undue hardship if he was sued by an injured person. The liability issue is better dealt with by sharing this with all citizens of Salinas, which means that the city should remain liable. The city attorney has done an excellent job holding down claim amounts. Let's keep it that way. Thank you.
Thanks, Jay.
I'm Dave Williams. I live on Swanner Circle in North Salinas, just up the hill from Santa Rita School. Within about 35 feet, we have five liquid amber trees, which I can address their conditions rather than magnolia. Liquid ambers multiply through their root system. Several times I've had to cut roots out of my garage, new trees out of my garage, out of my driveway, out of my lawn, even out of my backyard. I can only use half my driveway because the driveway's all tore up because of the root system. One of my neighbors, he keeps putting down asphalt so he can get in and out of his driveway, and he was told by a city official he shouldn't do that. One of my neighbors, every time he drives into his driveway, it goes clunk, clunk. So we do have a problem. Quite often, I've called the city. Originally, I talked to some guy named Tom, I believe was his name. And the name changes from year to year, I guess. And every time I call, I'm told, well, it's going to be 10 years before we can get to you. That's been over 10 years now, and I still haven't got there. I wish somebody would come by sometime. They put asphalt down on my driveway. 3 days later, there were big gaps in the holes where the asphalt was because it fell down inside the cracks. So we really do need to get rid of these liquid amber trees. They're not native here. Two trees standing side by side. One of them in the winter thinks it's summer, and the other in the summer thinks it's winter. One thinks it's fall all year round, and the other one, he just don't know. So we really do need to get rid of those trees, and quickly. And it could have been taken care of years ago, and it hasn't been. Thank you.
Okay, thanks, Dave.
Hello, my name is David, and my hearing is bad, so wave your hands or throw something if I go over. I don't tend to. I live not far away, and I never thought I could hate a tree until I met our liquid amber. And I'm sorry, Steve, but now I hate them. And I guess it's come up with other people, too.
He's having a special on them.
And so what I found, and I got to meet Victor, who's great. He was, in fact, repairing a neighbor's broken as a result of a liquid amber. He addressed ours as well. And I was told that if they were to remove it and put another tree in, it would have to be a liquid amber. So the city, at least on our block, evidently is constrained by local tastes as to which trees they can replace a tree that's taken out with. I would urge you to look at some of the, parameters has been tossed around a lot tonight, but just consider revising that policy. Why put in a sort of tree? Why replace a nettlesome tree with the same kind of tree? So that's one issue to look at. And I'd very much like Sergio's suggestion. Others had come up with it. I was going to say the same. I would like to see decomposed granite, use of other materials that are easier to keep up, easier to maintain, that look fantastic, environmentally sound. Just other materials that we might be able to use instead of concrete. Much easier to use. They move with the concrete. With the roots. Easier to get to problems if need be. And it's, I don't work for decomposed granite companies, but it does broaden the materials that we can use, makes the competitive process richer, brings down the cost to the city and to the homeowners. Thank you. And you guys are doing great.
Good. Thanks. Hey, you beat the 2-minute mark.
My name is Howard Coe. I'm a teacher and I live in North Salinas. My house was built in 1950, so it's 60 years old. I live 4 blocks from my mother-in-law, who has owned the house since it was built. They have replaced driveways. We have had some minor repairs. Occasionally we get trees trimmed. My neighbor was dating somebody who worked for a tree trimming service, and they came out and trimmed 4 trees. It was great. We have camphor trees, and they are, like everything else, tearing up the street. In North Salinas, on Main Street, they just put in new trees. What kind of trees are those? And when will we be replacing the sidewalks and curbs around that? It is a problem. The 50-50 proposition is a good proposition as long as my sidewalk is in excellent shape when I start, not the way it is now. One alternative would be no trees or fake trees. Some interesting options. So thank you very much.
I was going to ask you what kind of Christmas tree you had this year.
I didn't have a fake. I had
paper or plastic.
I had a fake tree in the family room.
All right.
A real tree in the living room, but it's gone now.
Okay. Got it.
Good evening, Mr. Mayor and the City Councils. I'm Andy Lucina. I live in Los Olivos Drive. I have a couple of questions. Can homeowners plant trees on the sidewalk without any problem to the city? And also, before the city come over and planted trees in front of this residence, do they have to survey the area to make sure that the main drain is not under the tree where they can plant these trees? And also, can the homeowners do the repair on the sidewalk?
Okay, we'll take all the questions and try and get as many of them as we can at the end.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming this evening.
Hello, Mayor and City Council. As many of you know, my name is David Mack, 426 Riker. Welcome, Kimberly and Steve, my new representative. I've been before you guys, I believe, 2 or 3 times talking to you about my sidewalk. I appreciate the temporary measures which were taken, especially the big black patch and the nice 54-foot long black streak that was laid down the center of my sidewalk, which actually looks worse than my sidewalk did before from an aesthetic point of view. However, the 6-inch hole in my sidewalk has been repaired. I will not say fixed, but repaired. And the reason I won't say fixed is that asphalt is already starting to come up, thanks to the water intrusion that has seeped through the rest of the sidewalk and gone underneath it. The main issue with mine, which is funny due to all the talk about trees, is there is not a single tree in front of my house. Therefore, my issue is not a result of trees. My issue is not just the sidewalk, it's the driveway apron, the entire 54 feet of sidewalk, the curb, and the gutter. Using the city's estimate of $3,500 to $4,000 for 20 feet of sidewalk and 50 feet of curb, gutter, and repair for concrete, materials, and labor only, that would put my expense to fix my sidewalk somewhere between $7,000 and $9,000. That is an unfair proposition for a property owner to take on due to neglect of either past homeowners or the city. The other question I have is, that estimate does not include the, if applicable, the permit I would need to pull for that, which I've heard is $110, a encroachment permit, or the repair of the street that I would have to dig up, as told to me by a contractor, to actually replace my curb and gutter. So that estimate, in my opinion, is actually low. When we talk about an assessment district, I will gladly pay the city $275 a month for 20 years, which equals $5,500 to avoid my $10,000 price tag.
Got it. Thank you. Okay, I'm going to note for the record, these will be the last two comments, and then public comment will. I'm going to stick with the 6:45, or the 5:45, so we can have council comment. So, who else wanted to speak?
Just me, and I've just been sitting in while.
All right. The final three, and then we'll cut it off. But I can tell, but Marianne, there's going to be a price to pay for this. You don't get to go last. You get to go second to last, because Mr. Finnegan is going to yield.
Good evening, Mr. Mayor, City Council members. Gloria Moore, 1310 Primavera, a 40-plus year resident in the city of Salinas, and I did have the pleasure of living on the same block as John and Yoshi Wong when John was very active with Public Works. I am a little bit more concerned about the process here, so I hope that when the City Council discuss this, you discuss a little bit more about how you think you're going to process this whole issue, and I would recommend that the council encourage all the people that attended and those who are not in attendance to present their written comments, concerns, solutions, but they need to be submitted by a certain date so certainly they can be analyzed. I'm also concerned that it doesn't. I tried to get a hold of a couple of the insurance agents that we work with through our business, and I was not able to speak directly to the owners, but I think some form of correspondence needs to go on with insurance companies as to how this may affect the property owner's insurance if they're moving some of the or increased liability over to them. Recently, if you haven't seen or taken the opportunity, PG&E is putting out brochures now on trees to plant that their main intent is they want to keep them out of the PG&E lines, but they are recommending smaller trees, which in fact do have a smaller footprint, which is their root basis. So you may want to consult with PG&E and their arborist or whoever put that together, and you can order those brochures from PG&E. We've ordered them, and I think they have some good trees, and it would be nice if those trees were locally available to people, not only to use as street trees, but otherwise. And my last point is, I think that point of sale will have a lot of opposition. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Hey, Marianne
Worden. Years ago when they planted my tree, I begged them not to plant the Mongolia tree, and they told me I had to take it. I had no choice. Now, the trees have gone into our neighbors' yards and ruined all their sewers. My sewer line doesn't go along by the tree. So I still have a tree. I think there's about two of our trees left, maybe three, on our block. When they chewed up the last one, tore it down, cut it, they left a hole. They covered it up a little bit, but they didn't pack it right. So now we have a hole in that spot. My suggestion is have bricks in your sidewalks, because if something happens, you just take out that brick, fix what's in there, because in a lot of cities, you do have bricks. In all your old towns, there's bricks for their sidewalks, and they've been there for hundreds of years, and there are trees around there. So you can remove a brick much easier and fix the problem than you can cement.
Thanks, Marianne. Okay, Brian.
Good evening, Mr. Mayor and council members. I'm Brian Finnegan. I'm here on behalf of the Future Growth Area people. And while the Future Growth Area has talked to the city about the sidewalk issue, and we've agreed to have sidewalk maintenance, not liability, but sidewalk maintenance included in lighting and landscaping district, assuming that the city places the same responsibility on the rest of the community, but we're not agreeing to be singled out for that treatment. A couple of points that my clients have asked me to make. One is that you not give, the staff recommendation is recommending that you direct the staff to prepare an ordinance consistent with the state statute. And I'd urge you not to give that direction until you read the entirety of the state statute, which is 10 sections. And those sections contain some hidden snakes, a couple of which you've heard tonight. One is that there's the provision applies to owners of lots fronting on any public street or place. In the Future Growth Area, there will be lots of streets where there are sound walls or other barriers that are between the street and the homeowners' property, and the homeowner has no access to that street or that sidewalk. Think about Baranda Road, for example, as it exists. There should be no liability for maintenance of sidewalk to people who have no access to that sidewalk. Secondly, we're concerned about the liability issue and its impact on insurance.